I'm Dr. Joseph Marianus Kujur. I work as the head of the Department of Tribal Studies at Indian Social Institute, New Delhi. I basically work in Delhi, which is somewhere here, but our area of operation is in 8 states of India, primarily the cow belt or the Hindi speaking states. Gujarat, Rajasthan are also two of the states which don't have Hindi as their main language, but nevertheless we have our activities going on in the central India. Some of the struggles that we are involved in, primarily our organization, which is known as Indian Social Institute, is a research organization and we engage in action research, and my department engages in any research activities pertaining to tribals or indigenous peoples or Adivasis as they are called. One of the main activities of our institute is to engage in this action research, and whatever findings we have, we normally make use of these findings to mobilize people, to sensitize people, therefore organize capacity building and training programs for our cadres, for our workers in these states. Number three, we also engage in advocacy at various levels. Advocacy at the grassroots level. We also support some movements, people's movements, tribal movements, and also we engage in policy analysis and policy intervention. So we have our friends in the government, in the administration. We try to influence the framing of the policy from the perspective of the tribals. And finally, we also engage in publications because we are convinced our findings, our researches should go back to the people, to the stakeholders, and therefore we try to make them available at a very, very cheap rate. And right now, I'm also engaged in a mega project which is given to us by Indian Council of Social Science Research, and the title of the project is Educational Status of Scheduled Tribes in Madhya Pradesh, and the funding is being done by the HRD Ministry, and the purpose is that this project is being conducted for Dalits as well as for tribals in 27 states of India, and therefore we would like the policies of the government in the future to be favorable to the scheduled tribes and scheduled castes. So therefore this is our intervention at one level, whereby we are trying to influence the policies of the government in favor of the tribals and the Dalits. Now, some of the success stories and things like that, it becomes very, very complicated or complex to talk about success stories, because we realize that our support of the movements, our facilitation or coordination with various organizations who are into struggles, various movements, for assertion of their rights and so on. This is a constant and consistent struggle, and therefore this is a process and not an end product. Therefore, very, very difficult to talk about successes, but we also have some stories like Nitra Hartfield firing range, whereby our organizations and our peoples, by sheer strong will of the people and by their strategy, they managed to keep the army at bay. They did not allow the army to occupy the land. And secondly, Koil Garo project has also been not been successful from the point of view of the government because of people's power, and people had to pay a price for it, because in the early sometime in 2002, about 8 people were shot dead by the police. Therefore, people had to pay a price for committing themselves to their struggles and to the life of dignity for these people, and therefore what a price they have to pay. But finally, I would like to say that the problem of the tribals is a structural problem, and therefore whatever soaps the government has been offering them in terms of reservation or in terms of various schemes and so on, these are not going to solve the problem permanently. They need to address the structural problems. Number two, many processes are going on right now, process of assimilation and homogenization, and less and less respect for diversity of these people, and therefore we have to come together, people who are engaged in various movements in different parts of the country, so that we synergize our efforts to reclaim our rights on resources, on land, forest, and other resources as well. And finally, there is no question of any disappointment or despondency, because there is opportunity, or there are opportunities. Therefore, our demand is to build up on the strengths of the community, and then if at all government wants our development, let the government not impose anything from top. Let the government be sensitive, and let the government allow us to develop from below, from whatever we have. We can build up on whatever traditions we have, and therefore definitely we have our hopes and aspirations to enhance the quality of our life, but we demand our basic rights, our fundamental rights to live and live a life with dignity. Thank you so much.